Navajo code talker breaks silence, destroys hash fake Indian Elizabeth Warren with epic one-liner. Not only is Senator Elizabeth Warren, DMA, lying about her Native American heritage, but it turns out one of the lawmaker's ancestors rounded up Cherokees during the Trail of Tears. According to Warren, her Native American heritage comes from an Oklahoma Territory marriage license application from 1894 by her alleged great-great-granduncle William J. Crawford. From here, Warren says her Native American heritage comes from that William J. Crawford's mother, O.C. Sarah Smith Crawford. Breitbart News reports. As I pointed out in my article here on Sunday, no evidence supports this claim. O.C. Sarah Smith Crawford had no Cherokee heritage, was listed as white in the census of 1860, and was most likely half Swedish and half English, Scottish, or German, or some combination thereof. Note, the actual 1894 marriage license makes no claim of Cherokee ancestry. But the most stunning discovery about the life of O.C. Sarah Smith Crawford is that her husband, Miss Warren's great-great-great-grandfather, was apparently a member of the Tennessee militia who rounded up Cherokees from their family homes in the southeastern United States and herded them into government-built stockades in what was then called Ross's Landing, now Chattanooga, Tennessee, the point of origin for the horrific Trail of Tears, which began in January, 1837. These were the troops responsible for removing Cherokee families from homes they had lived in for generations in the three states that the Cherokee nations had considered their homelands for centuries: Georgia, North Carolina, and Tennessee. While these involuntary home removals were not characterized by widespread violence, the newly displaced Cherokee mothers, fathers, and children found an oppressive and sometimes brutal welcome when they finally arrived at the hastily constructed containment areas. An estimated 4,000 Cherokees were warehoused in Ross's Landing stockades for months, awaiting supplies and additional armed guards the federal government believed necessary to relocate them on foot to Oklahoma. Warren is in the news this week after President Trump joked about the lawmaker's fake Native American heritage, referring to her as Pocahontas, during a honoring Native American code talkers. "You were here long before any of us were here. Although we have a representative in Congress who they say was here a long time ago. They call her Pocahontas," Trump said. One of the Navajo code talkers, Thomas Begay, broke his silence and destroyed Warren with an epic one-liner. "The Marines made us yell Geronimo when we jumped out of planes, and that didn't offend me either." Shocking nobody, Warren responded to the jab by calling President Trump's joke a racist slur during an appearance on MSNBC. "It is deeply unfortunate that the President of the United States cannot even make it through a ceremony honoring these heroes without having to throw out a racial slur," said Warren. Of course, Warren took the opportunity to fundraise off the joke. Predictably, Warren is out with a fundraising email on Trump's comments, tweeted AP's Zeke Miller.